memories. I love working here, but it's hard knowing that at any second...
God, I can't talk about it.
Nice job tonight, Adam. I heard most of those vandals got arrested peacefully. Things could have been so much worse.
God, I can't talk about it. What if another bunch of... Mr. Jensen! Oh, everyone's talking about what a great job you did saving the hostages. You're a real hero, sir. Can I help you find something?
Thanks, I'll find my way.
Of course. Have a good evening, sir.
Mrs. Reed?
Oh, Adam, I'm sorry you startled me. And please, call me Cassandra. You and Megan were together long enough. I was waiting for you.
Out here? Why not come meet me inside?
I don't know. I guess I'm just not ready. This is where you work, but to me, this is also the place where I lost my daughter.
I guess I never thought of it that way.
I'm sorry. It's not proper of me to come here and stir up bad memories, especially after what you've been through.
Yeah. A lot of things changed 6 months ago.
I can't get over how much they've changed you. At first, I couldn't even believe you were still alive. How do you handle all of this?
They did what they had to do to save me. And in a way, I can do more now than I ever could.
I'm glad to know you take it so well. Many of us wouldn't be able to cope so easily with such dramatic changes.
Can I ask why you wanted to see me?
Yes, of course. I'm sorry. I'm here about Megan. About what happened to her. Or rather, about the investigation into what happened.
What about it?
Well, simply put, I feel something is not quite right with the way the case was handled.
You think there was some foul play involved?
I do. Call it mother's intuition. But when speaking to some of the investigators, there were a lot of inconsistencies. And then I met this detective, a man called Chase. He agreed things weren't handled by the book, although he has no proof.
And now you want to find out more?
I'll never hear my daughter laugh at you're not the same.
I never got a chance to investigate the...
Thank you.
The first thing I'll need...
Good.
Why does a detective...
Oh...
I'm on it.
I don't really have anything against it. I just think it's disgusting.
Of these protests. These Lynn people are drunk. Rug pushers.
Mr. Jensen, David Seraph told me you'd be dropping by. I've just been reviewing the test results we received on you last week.
Should I start rolling up my sleeves?
Surprisingly, no. I see no trace of glial tissue buildup in any of your charts.
It's been 6 months, Doc. Shouldn't I be on neuropazine shots by now?
One would think, but these test results show no signs of implant rejection. If anything, the bond between tissue and electrode seems to be getting stronger.
So I'm free to go?
Well, Mr. Seraf did ask me to discuss another topic with you. You are aware that several precautionary measures had to be put into place during your first surgery?
Not all of my implants were switched on, I know.
The damage caused by the hematoma had to be taken into account. Your brain needed time to recover, to get used to the mechanical neural processors and turn them on naturally over time.
Cut to the chase, Doc. What does Seraf want?
He feels that you might be ready to speed up the activation process using special software known as Praxis Kits.
You mean I don't have to wait for my augmentations to kick in naturally anymore?
You can, if you prefer. But Mr. Seraf did make a generous donation to LIM in your name, thus ensuring that Praxis software linked to your particular neuro enhancements would always be available to you and you alone. Please, take a look.
Dr. LeBlanc, code blue. Dr. LeBlanc, code blue.
Very well, Miss.
Before. Is it true they stop your heart and the machine does your breathing?
More or less.
I know it sounds a little hair-raising, but we do it every day, several times over. It's a very safe.
Dr. Teasdale to X-ray.
Protesting is not against the law.
I know.
Adam, are you finished at the clinic?
For now.
Good. Right now I want to know who that corpse is. Head over to the police station and get his neural hub. And Adam, if you can't talk your way in, consider making a strategic retreat. There's got to be another entrance on the side of the building.
What would you say when you're kidnapped by a bunch of augmented soldiers and put in a concentration camp?
I ain't got nothing for you. Check with the man. And keep your hands where I can see them.
You got anything you want to buy or sell? I'm the guy you want to deal with. Everything's on the computer, right at your fingertips.
Thank you.
Be sure to tell all your friends. Just not the cops. It's your pleasure. Be sure to tell all your friends.
Grayson hooked me up with some real tight merch. Those art lovers get in my face now, I'm ready to pop.
Grayson? Where he at these days?
Yo, where you been, man? He been running shit through that abandoned gas station for weeks.
Oh, word? I wanted to get some upgrades for my Zenith 10 mil.
He can hook you up nice, man. If you go, tell him I sent you. I want a discount next time.
Word.
Hello there. Well, you must be Adam Jensen.
A keen observation.
Mrs. Reed told me you might pay me a visit. And don't take this the wrong way, but you're kind of hard to miss.
I'll try to take that as a compliment. She told me you might have information regarding Megan Reed's case and the attack on Seraf headquarters.
Oh boy, what a mess. Total pissing match. We had the feds on our ass, orders from three different departments, and pressure from so many lobbyists, it felt like being the scrawny new kid in the prison shower.
It is a very high-profile case. Mrs. Reed said you thought some procedures were overlooked.
You got that right. I mean, you know how it is. Mrs. Reed told me you used to be a cop. There's always cases where you see the lazy officers taking shortcuts. But this was different.
Different how?
Too much stuff got overlooked. People seemed way too eager to jump to conclusions, and every time I was remotely insistent, I got turned down by ranking officers. People wanted to bury this thing fast. That's never a good sign.
Surely you have something more substantial than this.
Yeah, well, that's where you come in. I got a couple of leads I could never fully investigate. I started poking around, but these government-type agents just gave me the creeps. I got scared. Months away from retirement, I didn't want to fuck things up. But you obviously have the means to get to the bottom of this.
So what have you got?
First off, there's a rumor that the order to close the investigation came from higher up, maybe even outside the local department. Anything like that would have passed through Captain Penn. There might be traces of this left on his office computer.
Guess I'll have to pay a visit to the local precinct.
Well, while you're there. There was an officer assigned to the case, Chet Wagner. He's not what you call a choir boy. And when he suddenly got brought on the case, I got suspicious. Somebody wanted him there. And I'm pretty sure he tampered with some of the evidence. You should talk to him. Find out what he knows.
Okay, I'll have a little chat with Officer Wagner.
You'll most likely find him in the lobby. He got retrograded from his conduct, and he takes depositions now. He won't budge easily, but I'm pretty sure you can find some dirt on him on his desktop. His office is on the third floor. He might find something there to help loosen up his tongue.
Anything else worth looking into?
Yeah, when the order came down to close the case, the bulk of the evidence was stashed in a storage locker. Maybe you can find some interesting stuff in there. It's on the alley right next to the station. The code is 4891. But I know an outside agency had access to that locker, so be careful.
Thanks for the heads up.
Bah, it's nothing. And, please... don't bother coming back here with details. Don't get me wrong, I'm glad to help. But the less I know about this case, the better I'll feel.
You said an outside agency may have tampered with a storage locker. What did you mean by that?
Well, I've heard that government agents may have locked up some of the more sensitive evidence in a safe inside the locker.
Come on, Chase. What are you not telling me?
Damn it! Okay, listen. I snooped around that locker before and found the safe code. But I kinda got caught by one of those guys. He knows I know, Jensen. If I give you the code, they'll know I talked. Call me negative, but I can't think of a nice outcome to that.
Come on, Chase. You're the good guy, the honest cop. In a police flick, you'd be the straight arrow. You know deep down you want to do what's right. That safe code could mean a lot.
Don't paint me as a hero, Jensen. I'm a regular guy. But you're right, though. I always try to do the right thing. The code is 7196. But do me a favor. Can you at least try to hack the damn thing before punching in the code? If I'm lucky, it'll be enough to throw them off.
I can never thank you enough for what you did.
Welcome. I'm glad you came. I can never properly repay you for what you did, of course, but I would like to help out any way I can.
What'd you have in mind?
There's a gentleman named Seurat who works in the area. His business causes him to move.
How does a guy like...
Growing up in my old neighborhood.
Access granted.
My pit bull augmented. Get him some, you know, cyber paws and cyber fangs and shit. Throw him in the ring. God, man. Yeah, it works. It's copyright, that shit. Documentation. Yo, we're gonna be rich, man. Access granted.
Access granted. Access granted. Access granted.
Anyone there?
Doesn't make sense. I know something was there.
Yo, Tyndall! I know you're here, man! Cut me off! Come on, man! I need my deposit! The shit hurts! Don't make me do something I don't want to do, Tyndall!
Access granted. Access granted. Thank you. Access granted. Access granted.
Jensen? What are you doing here?
I think you know why I'm here, Tyndall. I want Corella's security footage back.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm Seraph Industries' chief of security. I'm pretty sure I can find out about an edited security tape, so don't bullshit me.
Ah, shit. Listen, Jensen, I never wanted things to get this bad. I'm not a bad guy. I feel for Corella, I really do. But sometimes, for a good cause, you have to get your hands dirty.
Oh. There's a good cause now?
Oh, I see. You think I'm selling the stuff, right? I understand why this would seem like an obvious motive, especially to an ex-cop. But trust me, you shouldn't always take things at face value. I'm not selling the neuropazine, I'm giving it away.
Giving it away? To who?
To the people who need it. You think everyone gets augmented by choice? No. Shit happens. And then what? You're saddled with neuropazine injections for the rest of your life. And that shit costs money. But what choice do you have? Without the drug, you'll die. Rejection syndrome, crippling pain, that just ain't right. So I did the only decent thing to do. I stepped up. Thank you.
I can respect that. But blackmail is still blackmail. Corella wants out, and I'm here to make sure he gets out.
Man, this whole thing is becoming way too much trouble. I've even got two local pushers on my back because they say my philanthropic actions are undercutting their profit.
That's not your only problem. A gun-toting client was waiting for you in your apartment earlier.
Really? In my apartment? Shit, the dealers probably sent him. Tell you what, I'll deal with the client later. You take care of the dealers, and the footage is yours.
Okay, I'll help you out. But you better not be playing me.
You give me way too much credit, Jensen. I'm a security tech, not a hardened mobster. The two pushers go by the name PG and BK. They hang out in the alley near the back.
Deal.
What's your pleasure? Always a pleasure. How may I? See you soon.
Welcome to Lim International.
Would you say the police were overly violent?
Overly violent?
Dr. Chen,
will you be
called 217?
Always a
Eliza is so hot.
You're crazy. Nia Shia is.
Can't actually believe that purity first and freedom. Not yet.
never let T-Boss be booking me with no cards. I'll find him nasty.
Access granted.
These riots are David Seraph's fault.
How can you say that?
He has this air of arrogance.
Speaking from the tarmac at Wayne County Airport, Taggart called the attack
arrogance.
An extremely regrettable affair. I'd very much like to meet with David Seraph in person.
Doesn't mean he has the right to look down on us. In fact, most people who support augmentation technology have that sense of entitlement about them.
Welcome home, Mr. Jensen.
Access granted.
Hmm.
Re-establishing security system. See you soon, Mr. Jensen.
Jensen, long time no see. Jensen.
Yeah, I guess that's one way to put it. You look like...
Deep cover. I'm keeping tabs on the derelict rowballers for now.
Why do I get the sudden feeling you're about to include...
Because you're a
Go ahead. Okay.
You're an outsider.
Can't let...
All right.
Okay.
True.
So what am I...
Information.
Okay.
Yeah, I need...
A cop.
Cut.
What about the under...
O'Malley's crowd.
And he's gonna...
Exact.
And you want me to milk...
You haven't...
And what about the witness?
We're almost positive.
Prep him?
Well...
Okay.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Jensen, long time no see. Jensen.
Go.
I'm with...
Okay.
You're in.
And you want...
Yeah. Well...
Yes. May I help you?
Actually, I've been told by a mutual acquaintance that it might be the other way around.
Were you followed?
I'm a professional. I know how things work.
Well, you certainly look the part.
So what is...
Straight to business. A rare quality these days.
More than enough to get...
Perfect. Now, I warn you, this is not...
Who's the target?
Someone who won't be missed, I assure you.
You're telling me you went through all this trouble to hire me, just so I can eliminate a banger?
That would be a tech.
Kill a member of the Motor City Bangers, then plant them.
Hopefully.
You don't sell.
You, on the other hand, are start.
So what's the plan?
Pretty much.
What about innocent?
I won't.
I don't understand what you're getting.
You think too much.
So what is it I'm picking?
There's a rather luxurious apartment complex in Grand.
I need a more...
There's a small...
I can get inside there.
Look for no...
I guess that's it.
Access granted. Thank you. Access granted.
Don't get involved in this, asshole! Get out of here! Go ahead and run!
Thank you.
get lost.
Shit. Lost.
Thank you. You want to buy or sell something?
I'm a friend of
Really?
See ya.
Access denied.
D-Row cats is gonna get popped if they keep trying to tag over my shit.
Oh yeah? How so?
Got me a Hurricane TMP-18 from Surratt.
That's sick shit, man. I didn't know Surratt carried those.
Double T cutter. Something over there?
Hearing things, seeing things, man, I gotta lay off the hard stuff.
What the fuck's that?
Anyone there?
So far, Mr. Darrow has refused our repeated requests for an interview. This is Eliza Kassan, reporting to you live from Pycus.
Access to the
situation in Detroit has just flown through thanks to the arrival of William Taggart.
An extremely regrettable affair. I'd very much like to meet with David Sarab in person to offer my deepest sympathies and assure him that these attacks are in no way linked to Humanity Front. My people have worked tirelessly. solution to this dispute, and I unequivocally deplore the methods used by these hostage takers. Now, that being said, I do hope the UN...
Who is it? You gonna stay out there, asshole?
Mr. Taggart went on to express a sincere desire to stand in front of the General Assembly, united in their cause.
Son of a bitch! We need help here! Ain't got nothing yet! I see you,
William Taggart, celebrity author and founder of the Anti-Augmentation Organization.
This is what
I'm afraid.
Really? Okay, that's it. Thank you.
Look.
I've taken care.
Thanks, Jim.
Listen, Tyndall, I know you're trying to do the right.
Seriously? You'd really do that?
How many? Always.
Did you get it yet?
I got the foot.
Yeah. Listen, I got a.
Listen. I know.
Yeah, you're right, Adam. I know you're right. Listen. Thanks again.
Yeah? What do you want?
Information.
Then go bother the receptionist, Chrome Boy, instead of wasting my goddamn time.
Not that kind of information. I want to know about the Seraph Industries case.
Ha ha! And I want a blowjob and a vintage 05 bar GT, so I guess we both keep on dreaming. Huh? Metalhead?
I know you handled the critical evidence linked to the case, and I want to know about it.
First off, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. And second, even if I did, what makes you think I give a shit about what you want? Now, I strongly suggest you take your high-tech toaster-looking ass out of my way before I handle you.
Sincere desire to stand in front of the General Assembly with David Sarah.
Are you deaf?
You talk tough.
Now listen, man, we...
Talk.
Okay, look. I...
What was on?
Well...
Who asked you?
You think I know?
Requests for an interview.
What's up?
This is Eliza Cassini.
No traffic. Most of the streets...
These offices are off limits.
Back again to the...
Did you see it on the news? Eliza mentioned.
...were taken into custody this evening Following yet another anti-augmentation demonstration. This time, patients attempting to access the Second Avenue Limb Clinic found their...
Restricted area beyond this point, sir. Jensen, what the hell are you doing here? Station's supposed to be off limits to all non-essentials. You don't even fucking work here anymore.
That's right, off limits. I heard orders came down from pretty high up. If I had to guess, it has to do with that body in the morgue. Sounds like someone's
there. Stop, police!
Not me. Go have a look.
Hey, how are you?
You got what you wanted.
Listen, I can't promise anything. Not right now.
All the media speculation surrounding that hostage situation in Detroit has just...
I don't know. I heard there was a demonstration at the Limb Clinic.
William Taggart, celebrity author, founder of the anti-augmentation organization, Humanity Front. Speaking from the tarmac at Wayne County Airport, Taggart called the attack...
an extremely regrettable affair. I'd very much like...
Yeah, yeah, hang on just a sec. Shit. Jensen?
Haas. Surprised to see you here.
Yeah, well, I guess you're better at looking out for yourself than I am.
I don't have time for your self-pity. I need to get into the morgue.
That's it? Now, forget it. I don't know what's going on with that body down there, but my orders come from the brass. No one gets in. First thing you say to me after almost 2 years is you want something?
Should I have given you an order? You've always been very good at following those.
God damn. Where do you get off being so self-righteous? You think I like this? Look at me. From SWAT team commander to a crummy desk sergeant in the Tubit precinct. I don't need this from you. I get enough of it at home. So either come up with something better than your usual attitude, or you can just forget it because you came to me.
Right, that was a cheap shot, I'm sorry. I wasn't expecting you here, and I can't deal with our past right now. I know it's a risk for you, but I really do need to get into that morgue.
Oh, geez, Jensen. I don't see how I can possibly do this. There's so much heat right now, I'm telling you. The moment I open that door, I'm finished. I just got my life back together. This job is all I have. Don't make me do this.
Yes, your job is at risk. Yes, you've taken the blame for what happened in the past, but look, I need your help. And it's important. You got my word, whatever happens, I'll take care of you.
You didn't lift a finger for me back then. Why should things be different now? I'm fully aware what I did back then. The call was made, I took the shot. I killed the kid, and nobody else had to carry it. What kind of sick bastard comes around after 2 years and reopens a wound like that?
Come on, Wayne. Mexican Town was a complete bohica for both of us. I quit the force because of it, and for a while, I blamed you. But even when I was most pissed, I knew I could always count on you because you're a decent guy, Wayne. One of the best.
One of the best, huh? One of the best? You manipulative, self-serving jackass. You think I'm gonna fall for that? Get the hell out of the station, Jensen, because I am never gonna let you into that morgue!
Hey, boss. How...
Hello? Well, she knows what's what. That's
yeah, yeah. Hang on just a sec. Shit. Jensen?
Haas. Surprised to see you here.
Yeah, well, I guess you're better at looking out for yourself than I am.
I don't have time for your self-pity. I need to get into the morgue.
That's it? Oh, forget it. I don't know what's going on with that body down there, but my orders come from the brass. No one gets in. First thing you say to me after almost 2 years is you want something?
Should I have given you an order? You've always been very good at following those.
God damn. Where do you get off being so self-righteous? You think I like this? Look at me. From SWAT team commander to a crummy desk sergeant in a Tumut precinct. I don't need this from you. I get enough of it at home. So either come up with something better than your usual attitude, or you can just forget it because you came to me.
All right, that was a cheap shot, I'm sorry. I wasn't expecting you here, and I can't deal with our past right now. I know it's a risk for you, but I really do need to get into that morgue.
Oh, geez, Jensen. I don't believe this. I just got my life back together and you show up. When's it gonna end? You know the moment I open that door, it's all over, right? I'll be lucky if all that happens is I get fired. Is it really that important?
Yes, your job is at risk. Yes, you've taken the blame for what happened in the past, but look, I need your help. And it's important. You got my word, whatever happens, I'll take care of you.
That's good to hear. Everything goes back to that day. I shot a kid, but he was dead before I did that. He chose to make himself a weapon, and he could have gone through us like tissue paper with those augments of his. That's why you ran off. You just couldn't take that.
He was 15, Haas. In what world can you justify putting a bullet between the eyes of a 15-year-old boy?
I don't know. What happened wasn't my fault. You were in command, but when they told you to take the shot, you refused. So they told me. You and I, we were trained to follow orders, Jensen. I couldn't say no. I wasn't strong enough. Adam, please. I need to hear you say it wasn't my fault.
Wayne, it was a bad situation. You didn't do anything wrong.
Adam, thanks. The door's unlocked. I'll tell the guys to let you through. Now, I need to be alone for a while.
Don't know.
peaceful solution to this dispute, and... That being said, I do hope that you...
Access granted. Thank you. Access granted. Access granted. Grant. Access granted. Access granted.
Georgie. Answers, kid. We're talking about some serious fucking crimes.
Crimes? What are you talking about, man? My brother's missing and you want to charge him? Typical.
All right. Let's try this again. Tom, when was the last time you saw Lucky?
Doing an autopsy on that John Doe they brought in earlier. Morgue's off limits until he's through.
Again? The perp was trespassing. Who cares if Sarah's rent a cop killed him?
Murder's not the issue. The way I hear it, RJD's a cop.
No way.
According to the first responders.
Shit. How much you want to bet that story's about to change?
About time. You the home sec guy I was ordered to wait for? Tell Manderly I didn't get the memo until I was halfway through the autopsy. By then, it was too late to close him up again.
Right. So you recovered the neural hub?
Tricky bit of work that was. A few inches lower and the bullet would have fried more than just the PEDOT connectors. As it is, I can't guarantee you'll get anything useful out of it, other than the fact that it's been modified.
Modified? With what?
Some kind of wet drive. But hey, I didn't look. Ultraviolet means ultraviolet, and I know how touchy you guys get when it comes to matters of national security. He's all yours. The hub's been detached, but I left it in the skull, as ordered. Now, if you'll excuse me, I got paperwork to fix.
Boss, I got the neural hub. Looks like it's been modified with some kind of wet drive. Pritchard should have a look at it.
No, don't bring it here. Frank's not finished running his diagnostic, and I don't want to risk connecting any tech to our networks till he's done.
Especially if the tech is military. So what do you want me to do?
Take the hub to your apartment. I'll have Frank contact you there.
Thank you.
I hope you ain't here looking for trouble, my friend. That would be a mistake.
Have you found anything? Please, I've got to know what really happened to Megan.
I've investigated all of Detective Chase's leads. You were right. Something was off with Megan's case.
So, what did you find?
There were only...
You said...
I don't know. I got my hand...
Oh.
I don't know exactly.
So what...
No. I'm sorry, Cassandra. I wish I had more tangible answers to give you. But I did stumble on something I think you should have.
Oh, Adam. That... and,
I read the report.
Thank you.
Don't worry, Cassandra. This is not over. I don't know why.
I knew I...
How may I? Be sure to tell all.
Hanser, get lost!
Turn you. You ain't making it easy!
see? Didn't I tell you it was a stupid idea to let those...
What was that?
Stuff.
I don't know. Some Irish guy.
That's it? Some stranger offers to keep supplying us with enough firepower to take out a small...
What the hell?
Holy shit!
Never mind, man. It was nothing.
Getting all the stuff.
I don't know. Some Irish guy.
That's it? Some strange...
What the hell?
Damn it! Nothing here.
I heard that. Stop messing around.
Gunshot! Over there! Keep running, asshole! Don't push it, asshole. I ain't telling you again.
Did you get everything? We have to get that son of a bitch, Jensen.
I think I...
Excellent, Jensen. I knew I could trust you. My guys got their hands on Double T, and you identified the shipment. Apparently you weren't so subtle with the last part, but hey...
I paid a little... I managed to hack into his personal account.
Great work.
No, that about... I think O'Malley's...
Really?
O'Malley never mentioned any weapon. He just wanted the witness...
Just wanted the witness dead, huh? All right. Well, I've got enough evidence against O'Malley. Well, that's it.
It'll be my pleasure.
Perfect. My contact tells me O'Malley's gone back to his apartment. Go get him. I'll be waiting for you in... So? What happened?
He looked a bit tired and it made him grumpy. He's asleep now. All that's left to do is go in there and cuff him.
I've always liked your style, Jensen. I know I've said it a couple of times already, but... thanks. You've done a really good thing today. It's been a...
Where are you, Jensen? I haven't gone all night.
Hello, Pritchard. I'm almost in my apartment now.
Well, when you do get in there, connect the neural hub to your computer. I've created a secure tunnel, and I'll take over remotely.
You can access my personal computer.
Who do you think configured your security protocols?
Welcome home, Mr. Jensen. Thank you. Humanity Front. Speaking from the tarmac at Wayne County Airport, Taggart called the attacks
an extremely regrettable affair. I'd very much like to meet with David Sarum in person to offer my deepest sympathies and assure him that these attacks are in no way linked to Humanity Front. My people have worked tirelessly to find a peaceful solution to this.
Pritchard, the hub's connected.
I know. Now be quiet and let me concentrate.
I need his name, Pritchard, not his entire genetic history.
That's not his DNA. It's the data he was trying to steal from us before he... My God, Jensen. Your suicide hacker didn't kill himself.
You obviously didn't see his brain splattered all over the floor.
No, you don't understand. The wet drive modification in this chip, it allows someone to hack through you. It turns you, quite literally, into a human proxy.
So he wasn't working alone. Someone off-site was doing the actual hacking.
Exactly. And whoever it was tried to hide his location by using multiple satellites. But I may have just traced him to here. An abandoned factory complex in Highland Park.
Get me the address, Pritchard. Because if we're lucky, whoever pulled our terrorist strings might still be there.
Adam, it's David.
Let me guess. You're sending me to Highland Park.
Not just yet. Frank's figured out why the network's been compromised. There's a persistent transmission coming from Derelict Row.
Street gang territory?
Well, our dead friend was posing as an Antioch. Who better to hide with than the D-Row ballers?
Right. I'm on my way.